morning and welcome back to Kerith Kids TV, boys and girls. And I think, Ringo, there's lots of grown-ups that are watching as well. We hope you've had a really good week. Lots of the boys and girls, Ringo, have finished their home learning for summer. Some of them finish in this next week. Have you finished yours? No, Ringo's still got a few more days to go. But we hope, boys and girls, that you take time over the summer to do lots of things, lots of fun things that you love doing. Maybe playing with toys, playing with a garden, watch some movies, all those fun things that you love to do. Some of you have been baking this week, and in a moment we're gonna see a little photo from Ella, who lives in Bracknell, and made one of those zebra cakes that Joe made. But before that, we're going to see who has learned the memory verse from this week. Have you learnt it? Yeah? Ringo doesn't look quite convinced if he's learnt it or not. It was from Ephesians chapter 4, verse 29, and it was all about the kind of words that we speak to other people. It goes like this. All say it with me? Great. Watch the way you talk, say only what helps, each word a gift. You did it, Ringo. They did it as well. Well done, everyone. Let's look at that zebra cake now.
Celebrate our birthdays for this week. I might not be Dan McNabb, but hey, we've still got to celebrate birthdays. This week we've got two very special birthdays. So the first one is Bertie. So everybody say happy birthday, Bertie. And a message from your family, Bertie, says this. Happy birthday, Bertie. We hope you have a wonderful time camping in a new forest with your uncle, Philip. We love you so, so much. Lots of love from Mummy, Grandad, Num Num, Uncle Fizz, and Aunt Liz. Well, Bertie, we hope you have a great day and enjoy camping. We hope it doesn't rain. And the second birthday we have to celebrate. This one is close to Kerith Kids. This is our very own Dan McNabb, who turned 22 this week. So everybody shout happy birthday, Dan. So as I said, happy 22nd birthday, Dan. I've heard that your mummy, your daddy, your sister, brother, and of course your dog, Max, want to say a huge happy birthday and can't wait to see you grow in all things you do and one day to see your dream come true to work for CBeebies. We appreciate all you do. Have a great day. So happy birthday, Bertie and Dan. Now it's time to get up off your feet and show some of your best moves as we celebrate this week's birthdays.
Stories that all have something in common. Yes, they have animals involved in them. I wonder if you can listen out to see what animal is in today's story. It can be found in Luke chapter 15, and I'm going to read it from this book, the Jesus Storybook Bible. Jesus told this story about a boy who ran away. Once upon a time, there was a boy and his dad. Now, one day, the boy gets to thinking, maybe if I didn't have my dad around me telling me what to do, telling me what's good for me all the time, I'd be happier. He's spoiling my fun, he thinks. Does my dad really want me to be happy? Does he even really love me? The son had never thought that before, but suddenly he doesn't know anymore. So the son goes to his father and says, Dad, I'm better off without you. I can look after myself. Just give me my share of your money. Well, the father's really sad, but he won't force his boy to stay. So he gives his son what he wants. The son takes the money and goes on a long, long journey to a far-off country. And everything's wonderful and perfect for a while. He can go wherever he wants, do whatever he wants, be whoever he wants. He's the boss. He is free. Sometimes he gets a strange, hungry, homesick feeling inside his heart. But then he just eats more, or drinks more, or buys more clothes, or goes to more parties until it goes away. But soon, his money runs out, and so do his friends. He ends up getting the only job he can find, feeding pigs. One day he is so hungry and so desperate, he even tries to eat the piggy food. Oh, what am I doing? He says suddenly, as if he's woken up from a nightmare. He spits out all of it, out of his mouth. Ugh. My father is rich, and here I am in a pigsty eating piggy food. He wipes his mouth and dusts himself off. I'm going home. As he starts for home, though, he begins to worry. My dad won't love me anymore. I've been too bad. He won't want me for his son anymore. So he practices his I'm sorry speech. All the time, what he doesn't know is that day after day, his dad has been standing on the porch, straining his eyes, looking into the distance, waiting for his son to come home. He just can't stop loving him. He longs for the sound of his son's voice. He can't be happy until he gets him back. His son is still a long way off, but his dad sees him coming. What will the dad do? Fold up his arms and frown? Shout, "That'll teach you!" No, that's not how this story goes. The dad leaps off the porch, races down the hill, through the gap in the hedge, up the road. Before his son can even begin his I'm sorry speech, his dad runs to him, throws his arms around him, and can't stop kissing him. "Let's have a party," the dad shouts. "My boy's home. He ran away. I lost him, but now I have him back."
Hello, Kerith Kids. We are back. We're doing PE with Joe. Kids, parents, it's time to get up on your feet. I know you've been missing this. So, for this week's story, it's all about the prodigal son, just to begin with. Let's get a little bit of jog on. A little bit of jog. So the son, he goes up to the father. He's like, "Hey, I want all my possessions and my money, and I want to run away. So what we're going to do is we're going to do some lunges. So go to the left, and then we're going to grab our possessions. A lion, because you never know. And then got a dinosaur, and then we're going to stretch to the right, and then we're going to grab, I've got a dog, and then keep on stretching, and then we've got, I have not it, and then we're going to run away, just like the prodigal son did. He ran, so run as fast as you can on the spot, who could be the fastest. But then the prodigal son, what happens is he starts to throw away all his possessions. So he throws everything away, and then he's left with nothing. So what we could do next, we're gonna get on our hands and knees, and we're gonna do mountain kicks, pretending to be a pig. So put your hands and knees, and then stretch. And I wanna hear your best pig noises. So go, and then gonna do some more. And then the prodigal son, he gets up, and he realizes, I don't want to be this anymore. So he starts to go back to his father. So walk on the spot, get his knees up, nice and high. Who can get them the highest? Give us a cheer if you're from Bracknell, you're the highest, or West White. What about Windsor, Blackwater Valley? And then we're gonna start to jog. So start to jog on the spot. And this says that I really gotta go back. So then we're gonna run. So pick up the pace. And then we're gonna sprint really, really quickly to get back to the father. And then we are back to the father. And then what he does, we're gonna stretch nice and big. And then the father, he gives us a massive hug. So stretch. And then we're gonna hug him. And we realize the son has been very naughty. So we ask for forgiveness. So we're gonna reach. And then we're gonna touch our toes and humble ourselves and ask for forgiveness. And then stretch, reach,
And he's back. There you go. It's PE with Joe done. Did you notice the animal in this week's story? Of course it was the pigs, wasn't it? Don't like the sound of eating those pigs' food though, do you? This week, we're going to learn a little bit more about that story, but beforehand, we're going to learn this week's memory verse, which is from Ephesians chapter 4, verse 32. And it goes like this. Be kind and loving to each other. Forgive each other just as God forgave you in Christ. That's a really important verse to learn, and it links in really well with what we're learning about this week. Have a go and try and learn that at home this coming week. In the story, we learnt about the son that ran away from his dad. He thought he knew best. He thought he could do things on his terms, but then he came back, didn't he? Came back to his dad. Two things really stood out to me in this story. The first thing was that when he ran away, the dad could have stopped him. His dad could have said, "No way are you going away. No way am I giving you my money." But he didn't. Because he gave his son the choice. He gave his son free will to do what he wanted with his life. The second thing that really stood out to me was when he came back. He could have had all kinds of reactions from his dad. His dad could have been grumpy or cross or given him the silent treatment. But no, his dad ran towards him, giving him hugs and kisses, arms wide open, because he was so excited to have him back again, because he loved him so much. When Jesus told this story, he wanted us to know that God is like the dad who never stops loving us. And we, people, can be like the son who sometimes think we know best and want to run away from God. Have any of you ever done anything that you haven't been very proud of? I know I have at times. And I remember when I was younger, if I did something wrong, if I messed up, once I accidentally poured a whole bottle of my mum's favourite perfume on her carpet and I knew I was going to be in trouble. So what did I do? Did I go and tell her? Did I run towards her? No, I went and hid in my bedroom because I didn't know what to do. I was scared, I was ashamed, I was afraid, and I ran away from her rather than to her. But of course, when I told my mum, after a little while, she was okay about it and we moved on from it and she forgave me, and at no point during that did she stop loving me. Well, God loves us even more than our mums and dads love us, which is amazing to think of. He loves us so much and there's nothing that we can do that will make him love us less. And because of Jesus, because of what Jesus did for us, we can be forgiven. Anything that we have done is already forgiven because of Jesus. But we have our choice, like the son had a choice, of whether we run away from God or whether we run to him. In Kerith Kids, we have a prayer that we use when we want to say to God that we're sorry and please be our forever friend. It's called the ABC prayer. And many of you will have prayed that before in kids' work. Some of you will have prayed it more than once, and that's great too. But we want to give an opportunity today for you in your homes, with your grown-ups, to pray that prayer. And some of you will be praying this for the first time. Because we don't have to run away from God. We can run towards him. We can stay close to him. When we journey through our life with Jesus as our forever friend, there is nothing better. The words are going to come up on the screen, and grown-ups, and encourage you to help your children with this. Help them through it. We're going to pray this prayer together as the words come up on the screen. Dear God, I admit that I have said, thought, and done things that are wrong, called sin. I believe that Jesus is God's Son and he loves me and he died to save me from my sins. I choose to ask Jesus to be my forever friend and saviour and to follow him for the rest of my life. Amen.
We're going to do family prayers now.
Hi, my name's Owen.
Hi, my name's Kit.
we're going to be saying things that we're thankful to God for. I'll start. Thank you, God, for food, football, family, my school friends like Charlie, Alfie and Jacob, school, hospitals, camping, roller coasters, houses, church and ball games.
I thank God for family, food, water, football, gardens, homes, nurses and doctors, churches and Nintendo and TVs and bike rides and building sandcastles and Legoland and school.
Kids at home, you might want to also think about things that you're thankful for when you pray. We're now going to spend some time saying sorry to God. So let's close our eyes. Kids at home, you can do this too. And just pray to God about the things you want to say sorry for this week. Amen. Now we're going to spend some time praying about things we want to ask God for, we want to say please for.
Dear Lord Jesus, please keep everyone safe and make the coronavirus go away. Amen.
Dear Lord Jesus, please help all of the Kerith kids to have an awesome summer holiday. Amen.
Let's pray together. God, thank you for all you do for us. We're sorry for the times we don't stay close to you. Please keep all the Kerith kids safe and close to you, including Deo and Alondra. Amen!
Boys and girls, welcome back to this week's Dan vs. Joe. Last week we saw them do a blind touch test. This week they're going to do a blind taste test. What are they doing back there? What they don't know is the taste test is going to be baby food. Don't tell them, okay? We're going to start it soon. Okay, Dan and Joe, we are here. You have a blind taste test this week. Are you excited at all the yummy food I've got for you?
It does not smell good, whatever it is.
What? What's wrong with my cooking? So, in front of you, there are five small containers of food, which you have to taste.
Tell
me what it is. We're gonna take it in turns. Let's start with Dan. Can you do the other one, the other end? Just take your hand away from the jar so I can see what it is. Yeah, that's the one. What do you think it is?
That is nasty.
Come on, this will be lovely for you.
Is it like mashed up baked beans?
No.
Wait, or like, you know, mashed up, you know, the alphabet spaghetti? Is it tomatoes?
It's Italian, it's got tomatoes in it. It's your first bolognese. Well done, bolognese. You didn't get it though. Joe's not looking
I'm
happy.
I'm so nervous right now.
Right, you've also got an Italian dish on your, that's the one, you'd use that one. There you go, that one there. And your spoon is just here.
I'm so nervous. Can I smell it? No, I don't want to.
Go for it.
It's in a nice jar.
Then we should speed it up a bit, otherwise we're going to be here all week.
Oh! Tastes like cottage pie.
It's not cottage pie.
Do you want to make any more
noise? It's Italian.
Lasagna?
Not really. It's cheesy tomato pasta. Back over to Dan. Right in front of you, Dan. Let me show them. Yeah. One of your five a day, I reckon this.
Oh, okay. I like veg. What is that noise for?
Come on. We're already on 5 minutes.
Okay. All right, ready? I don't think I have to eat it. Is it Swede?
Nope. Come on, nice big mouthful. Open them wide.
Choo-choo.
Oh, is it potatoes?
Nope.
Mashed potato?
No, cauliflower cheese. Oh. Joe, your one. Ooh, look at this yummy one, everyone. There we go, there we go. This is yummy.
I could smell it. Oh, that's peas.
Well done, she's got one, someone's got one. It's peas, it's peas.
I hate peas.
No. Last one, fruit course now.
Okay.
So, you've got...
Oh, this one feels softer.
Go for it. If you can name me, there's four fruit in this, one of the fruit.
How do babies
I'll give
this?
You a point.
Okay. Not good. I don't know. I'm not taking another one. Avocados.
No, that's apple, apricot, banana, and orange. Joe, stop eating it, stop eating it.
They're not nice.
Last one we have here. There you go. If you can name me a fruit in this. Joe's leading at the moment.
Oh gosh. Oh. Is that like strawberries, raspberries?
You've got berries in there. See if you can name me the others for full marks.
Oh, it tastes so familiar. Is that like blueberry?
Well, it says berries, apple, and banana. You can take your blindfolds off and see what you've eaten.
No, no. Did I
Why is it green?
Who feels sick?
Nasty.
This one's quite nice.
That is disgusting.
Joe, you're the winner though.
Am I? Mouthful's that.
Boys and girls, you're nearly on summer holidays. Some of you might already be. We hope you have an absolutely great time in your summer holidays. Don't forget to keep checking in with us every Sunday. And if you have got a birthday coming up, get the grown-ups in your house to email us in your birthday shout-outs by Wednesday evening to kerith.church. We hope you've had a great time. Don't forget to learn the memory verse. We'll see you next week. Bye.